Welcome to the Custom Connections and AI Connections with SolidSteel Parametric for Autodesk Inventor tutorial. To show the connections, of course, we need a demo assembly, which I'll quickly build in the background while I show you what to expect in this video. I will sort the custom connections in order of simplicity, so we will start with those that we can create from a combination of SolidSteel connections, to more complex connections that also include standard Inventor parts or more advanced machining. As we look at the feature in detail, the first custom connection in particular takes longer in the video because we cover all the features once. However, you can also find the different connections and chapters in the video description for quick navigation in the video. Well, the demo assembly is almost finished, and as you can see, I've already used three simple end plate connections. Here comes the fourth. I'll show you later in the video how we can speed up these simple joints using AI connections, but for now let's find out what a custom connection actually is. As a template, we will create an end plate connection with the tool of the same name. We select a beam and a connection face and get a preview. We don't need a double end plate here, so I uncheck it and the preview changes accordingly. We want the holes to be transferred to the beam, so we activate propagate holes, and by clicking on assemble we open the part selection where we can define the bolted connection in a simple and detailed way. Confirm and the bolted connection is set. We can also make other changes, such as changing the thickness of the end plate, and then confirm the dialog to insert the end plate. Nothing new so far, we add some ribs. We select the column and define the position of the rib pair with a second click. In the preview we see only one rib, but as long as the single rib option is not checked, two ribs will always be inserted symmetrically in the profile. Using the rib offset we can position the rib flush with the bottom edge of the beam. Now it is correct, we can confirm the ribs to insert them. Two more ribs, the top edge for reference, and the offset set so the ribs are flush with the top of the column. Now, these were all standard features and it was all done quickly, but where is the custom connection and what is the benefit? So we start the Learn Custom Connection feature, and in the dialog we see the possible selections in the upper part. Here, with our simple connection of standard solid steel parts, it is enough to select the cross beam, which is our horizontal beam, and the end beam, which is our column on which we have selected the connection face. In the dialog, we see that all solid steel connections present on the two beams are listed. When we move the mouse over the connections are highlighted, including the profiles involved. So we select this end plate, these ribs, and also the top ribs. We don't have any solid steel cuts, nor any external parts and external cuts. We can give the custom connection a name, and confirm it to add the connection to the database. Okay, so we've created our first custom connection, even though we can't see anything of it yet. Now let's move on to the advantages of the custom connection and select the Build Custom Connection feature above. The dialog requires only the selection of the cross beam and end beam as input. The list now shows only the custom connections that match the selected profile size and beam orientation, including the tutorial connection one we just created. We see the preview, which now includes the end plate as well as the ribs as expected, we can confirm. A few seconds later, the complete connection is inserted, including all the bolts. This is incredibly fast and combines the 3.5 steps otherwise required into just a few clicks. The step counted as a half is the definition of the bolted joint, which also only needs to be done once for normal end plate connections and would be defined directly for subsequent end plates. Okay, that was fast, but we can speed it up even more using the AI connection feature. To do this, we will revert our demo assembly back to the state without the connections we just added. So we add our custom connection again. The first steps are exactly the same as we just saw, select beams, select connection, preview, okay. Here below, however, we still have the enable AI connection option, which, in simple terms, allows geometrically identical installation situations to be found automatically in the first step. In our case, AI Connect will now look for HEB240 beams that meet other HEB240 beams at a 90 degrees angle. In our demo, this also applies to this beam and the column where the selected connection would not fit because of the rotation of the column. Another criterion is whether a connection already exists or not. But beyond that, there are the AI connection filters that we find here, and by activating them, orientations, rotations and directions are also taken into account. I simply enable AI connection without any other filters and it suggests connections. Okay, the three locations found are initially correct, but the connections are displayed in yellow and not green. This means that the connection could not be defined as 100% clear. We can correct this by activating the filters. I simply enable all of them, which also corresponds to the default settings, and check enable AI connection to restart the search for installation locations. Okay, now we can see that all the locations found for our connection are green and therefore clearly defined. That's how it should be, we can confirm. This will take a few seconds and then our custom connection will be inserted at all four places simultaneously. Of course, this works in assemblies of any size, but even in such a small assembly it can save time. Well, let's move on to the next custom connection. From now on it will be faster, although the actual connections will be more complex. Here we have a joint between two rectangular tubes with a hand hole, or in this case a tool hole, on this side to access the nuts. This is an interesting connection because it combines a standard solid steel connection, an end plate, with an external cut. No problem, we start learn custom connection again, select cross and end beam, and the end plate is displayed in the list, which we select. We do not have any solid steel cuts, nor do we have any external parts, but we have already seen the external cut and we want to add it. We activate the cut feature selection and select it in 3D. Now all we have to do is name it and confirm the dialog to save the custom connection to the database. Okay, let's test it right away. Here are the rectangular tubes without a connection. We start the build custom connection dialog again. Select cross and end beam. Choose our tutorial connection 2 from the list and see the preview. Logically, we don't need the AI connection option with only two tubes in the assembly. We can confirm directly and the connection including the cut is inserted. We can now use this connection again and again if the profiles and angles are identical, so that we can, for example, construct a very long ladder with many rungs very quickly and easily. Okay, that was another relatively simple custom connection. Now let's make a little more complex one. We're going to create a custom frame corner. Frame corners are designed quickly in solid steel parametric. It just takes a relatively long time in the assemblies because you repeat the steps over and over again if you do it without a custom connection. We want to save this unnecessary wasted time. Here is our frame corner template that joins two HEB240 profiles. These are solid steel standard connections combined with two sheets that were not created with solid steel, but with Inventor standard features. We switch to the solid steel tab and start the learn custom connection feature. As before, we select the cross beam and the end beam, and we select the end plate and the three pairs of ribs from the list. Up to this point, it's exactly the same procedure as for our first connection. Of course, we still need to add the external parts via the component selection. We can do this in 3D or via the feature tree, here the haunch plate and here the lower chord, which will then be listed in the dialog. Now all we have to do is give it a name and confirm, as we know by now. To test this, we simply use the assembly from the beginning again, start the custom connection feature and select the usual beams. In the list, we now see not only the tutorial connection 3 we just created, but also the first custom connection. That's clear, it's the same installation situation, so all matching connections are listed. We select the new connection and of course we can use the AI connection again. All the right places were found, looks good, we confirm. This will take a short while. I let it run in real time. The time needed is the pure computing time the software needs to place all the parts. That's 164 parts, including bolts, washers and nuts. Okay, for more complex connections, it's clear that using custom and AI connections is worthwhile. But you can also save time with very simple standard joints. Obviously, no one likes to manually insert repetitive connections in large assemblies. Even if it's just an end plate that you can add with a few clicks, it's still monotonous work. So we take a standard double end plate, 30mm thick should do it, and we just place it. As I said, it's quick enough, but I don't want to spend hours repeating this. So we start learn custom connection again and select beam and column. Of course, the dialog now covers our end plate. Now you can see it again. All we need to do now is select this one end plate, give it a name, and save it as a custom connection. Now I can immediately use the build custom connection feature to simply insert the end plate and add all the others by selecting enable AI connection. It doesn't matter if there are two more like this or even 100 more in a larger assembly. Okay, Saving can't hurt, and then we'll connect the two frame halves in a moment, which are currently still loosely connected. Here I have created a splice joint that we will use as a template for another custom connection. We know the steps by now. Learn custom connection, select both beams. If you are wondering which beam is the cross beam and which is the end beam, in this linear 180 degrees arrangement, it doesn't matter in which order you select them. The only important thing to know is that it is also possible to create custom connections for butted profiles. Now we have the manual boltings displayed here, which we simply select. There is also a separate video on manual bolting that is linked in the description. Now we need to select the external parts, which are the plates. I'm doing this from the feature tree so I don't have to rotate the model to select the parts. That's all the parts. We can assign a name and also save this custom connection to the database. Okay, back in the demo assembly, we are ready to use our custom splice joints. Selecting beams, tutorial connection 5 and execute. I should have clicked on the plus instead of execute. That way the dialog would have stayed open as we will need it again in a moment. So, let's do it again. But you can already see that you can insert highly complex connections with really few clicks and super fast. The second splice is now finished. What we still need are the stage beams, which we will quickly insert and then connect with clip angles. The IP180 profiles are suitable for this. Height offset to top so that they are flush with the top of the existing structure. The clip angle connections are also the last custom connection for this video, and they also include a solid steel cut, which we have not had in any connection so far. The model is now complete in terms of the beams. I have already prepared the template for the angle connection, here it is. This connection consists of the double clip angle connection including the bolted connection, and there is also a rib on the other side. We start learn custom connection again. First select the stage beam and then the other beam. We see the connection and the rib in the first list and also the cope cut in the cut list. We select the components. It is also nice to be able to see the rib without rotating the model thanks to the transparency. Of course, we also want to have the cope cut and select it before we assign and confirm a name again. Back in our familiar demo assembly, we use custom connection again, select the appropriate beams, and then select the custom connection from the list. We only want to do this once, so we also select enable AI connection. This looks good and correct. We can confirm and all four double clip angle connections are inserted. While the computer is working for us, I'm going to show you where in the settings we can delete custom connections that are no longer needed to remove them from the database. Okay, the clip angle connections are now finished as well. Our design is now fully detailed. The video was long, but the combination of custom and AI connections is a super powerful way of working that every user should be familiar with. If you would like to learn more about SolidSteel parametric for Autodesk Inventor, please feel free to watch the video suggested here. It's worth it. Thank you for watching to the end and see you next time.